Hello again, everybody. This is Mr. Everything. I'm coming at you with another Star Citizen live gameplay. What I'm doing in this live gameplay, I actually came in with a mission. I'm going to go to the Yella asteroid field, and I'm going to fly around that asteroid field probably two or three times. Or zigzagging probably through the asteroid field until I can find this large wreck. People are talking about how there's this special wreck out there. I mean, you don't collect any extra cargo or anything like that. No extra UEC. Nothing like that. It's just an amazing fact that it's a large wreck. And I haven't seen that. I've seen regular size wrecks all throughout the various mission sites and stuff like that, but not one that's extra large. And I think these guys are bullshitting, because I've been around the Yellow Asteroid Field a number of times. I wasn't actually specifically looking for that, but that's what I'm going to be doing tonight. It might take me an hour, it might take me two. We'll get a shot. If we get attacked, what? Search for the huge wreck Ion. What? No, that's wrong name for my chat, my stream. Let's fix that. We gotta fix that. It should be huge wreck in Yella. That's what it should be. So let's refresh this. Bleep. Yeah, there we go. I poured this orange juice like 2 hours ago. Now why do I have a black screen? And why does it still say War Thunder? Oh my gosh, this stream's all screwed up. Let's just turn this music off, yeah. It says War Thunder. What the hell? I changed that to Star Citizen. I know I did. And I clicked on it. I'll see if my advanced settings are jacked. No, they're Star Citizen 2, so that's good. That says Star Citizen. Okay. Well, why do I have a black screen? Alt tab. Let's do this. Got the Star Citizen music, right? All you see is a load screen. I got the black screen of death. Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to. Crap. let's launch it again. All right, there we go. Give it a shot. Okay, this time I even have my Discord up. I see that the B Raven and Johnny Hyrule are on. They're logged in, but. Yep, so now we're just, okay, here's the universe. There we got that. So far, so good. I'll try not alt tabbing out. Hey guys, thanks for joining the stream. We are getting ready to search for the extra large wreck that's in the Yella asteroid field, that I've heard rumors that there's an extra large wreck out there the size of a capital ship. Well, we'll see. It's not, it's not an actual capital ship. What it is it's just, you know how the wreckage is throughout the universe, how the, you know, you have those spots that you can go collect, you know, alcohol and guns and stuff like that. Supposedly there's one that's extremely large like it was a capital ship at one point. So we're going to go check that out and see if we can find that. If we can, we can. If we can't, we can't. You know, stuff like that. There, sorry, I just alt-tab like I said I was going not to do, and I just did it anyway. Come on, I'm trying to move this. I'm streaming it at 60 FPS. Oh, sorry, don't want to do that. That takes up too much of my FPS in the game. Ah, see, now I'm all screwed up. Let me get this down to 30 like I wanted it to be. Does it say I've got to restart? Probably does. Apply. Okay. Start streaming. There it is. I woke up. Or I'm not waking up. Wait a minute. What the heck is going? This is a new bug! Look at those eyes! I don't have. What the heck? I don't even have that helmet. That's not the. That's not even me. Who is this guy? Somebody's here before me. Okay, so now we go in, we all tab out, and we close the launcher. Because apparently that eats up a lot of my streaming power too. Okay, so launcher is closed. Then we do r_motion_blur0 to get rid of the motion blur. And I don't know what this skeleton instance thing's going on. I've never seen all that junk before. Okay, so here we go. Me and my 20 FPS. We are going to go search for the wreck. I think I'm going to use a saber because it's fairly fast. Dude, what a dick. All right, so... Boop, 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 boop.
Unfortunately, our automated system is unable to access that ship at this time. Please try again later, or select a different ship. Unfortunately, our automated system is
really
unable to access that ship at this time. We apologize for any inconvenience. Welcome. Please try again later, or select.
Yeah, I'll try again later. Watch this. Exit the menu. Are you sure you want to go to the menu? Yes, I'm sure I want to go to the menu. Now I have no clicky sounds. Okay, now I do. I was wondering. Just got done playing a little bit of War Thunder. And now I remember why I left that game. Man. So much Russian OP. Man, the Russians are OP in that game. Man. I was playing tanks. Bam. Playing planes. Bam. Doesn't matter. Russian OP. I consider playing World of Tanks just because, you know, I don't know. World of Warplanes wasn't that good, though. But just can't wait for more content in Star Citizen, new flight model. I heard they were maybe going back on that, like they might not be doing it. I really hope they do, because there's something needs to be done, and don't let the minority cry about it. You need to put it in the hands of everybody and then let us cry about it. But Or compliment it. You should actually have like a forum post. Or maybe to log in, you have to answer this question. Do you like it or do you not like it? Or I haven't tried it yet. Something like that. Okay, so let's see. Have I done this? Or, I guess it would stay, right? If I didn't actually log out. Yep, he's right. Okay. Now we're gonna go look. Now we're gonna go look for that wreck. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm gonna do a grind my gears type video for the sale that was going on last week, or maybe it's still going on for the Super Hornet, about how people are whining bitches. But I might not. So many other people have already done that. But I gotta put my 2 cents in, though. Yep, I got my little vape pen in my hand. It's actually a healing pen, but you know. Yeah, they gotta fix the rifle sights and stuff. That's what I want them to fix. And they're probably working on that with the whole Starbring thing too. And my understanding is it's finished. It just needs to be released to us. So, yeah, get on the ball and get that done. Hopefully, some people are PTUing it. I don't know. No, I'm not.
Aegis combat assist activated. Systems green. Launch complete.
Are they really green?
Landing gear retracted. Begin scan.
There's Yelp.
Begin
That's where
scan.
We're heading.
Bottom travel initiated.
Yay!
Bottom travel complete.
So now I'm gonna. How am I gonna find this thing? You know, that's the question. I'm here now, but how the hell am I going to find this wreck, right? It's supposed to be a giant wreck. Yeah, I know I can look around for like green lights and stuff, but. And I've flown through. I don't know if it's on the outside edge or if it's on the inside edge. So I guess I'm still going to have to look for the green lights, but I'm just looking for a large wreck. I don't know how I'm going to find it. I'm not looking for a Grimhex. I already know where that is. And unfortunately, guys, this is going to be very boring, I think, because all I'm going to be doing is flying through the asteroid field. Sorry, I'm reading the chat and not searching. Here's some big rocks. You would think a big wreck would be near some big rocks, right? Don't know. I don't know. Oh, yeah. I forgot. Now let's see if this works. Nope, my Star Citizen thing's not set up. Okay. Alt tab. Hope I don't run into a rock while I'm alt tabbed out. Let's go to Star Citizen. Back to the game. I had a macro set up for my mouse. There it is. Boop. I have my mouse sensitivities and all that set up, so once I hit the Star Citizen profile, it just automatically sets everything the way I want it. Okay. You know, button commands and all that. This is like looking for a haystack in the middle of a bunch of other haystacks. Or a needle in the haystack, as they say. I still got my ballistic cannons, that's good. Figured they would have worn off by now, because you only get like 7 active days when you buy them in the store. The wreck store. Wreckage! If you see it, holler out in the chat, you know. How's everybody doing? You guys doing all right? Join the show. Hey, Mr. Everything, what's he saying? Might be better to look like this. Nah. Disorienting that way. This is good. Okay, this way. This way is good. See a bunch of people in chat, but everybody's, or you know, watching the video, everybody's being very quiet. And that's fine. I'm that same way, man. When I'm watching or when I'm playing, I'm locked in and I'm in the zone, and I usually don't like respond to chat anyway, so it's all good. It's all good. What I think is crazy is there's people that'll jump into a chat and they'll say, "Hey, give me a shout out." That's not the way it works. Those are the ones that I will deliberately not mention their names. I mean, why would you do that anyway? I don't get it. I don't get the whole, "Hey, give me a shout out." I was getting ready to hold shift and look around, but that's my War Thunder profile. I just got finished playing. It should be Z. There we go. Now I can look around. Oh my gosh. I don't see any Lars Wreck yet. Hey, Comlink restored. Yay! Yeah, whatever. Comlink down. Oh, well. Didn't last very long. I'm also not seeing any green lights like you normally... I'm not really looking super hard. But the green lights are where that tell you where the wrecks are, right? Because they... Oh, right. It's been restored already. Damn, they're having like a little battle over there by the Comlink. And you would go to these green lights, and that would be like where a wreck would be. And then you would like EVA over to the boxes, and you would collect up all the different goodies, right? Well, I haven't seen any green lights. They're very subtle too. They're like so small and blurred out. They kind of blend into the background. You would never even, and the HUD is green, so it kind of blends in with that too. So you'd never know that you were looking at one unless like you're really focusing. Yeah, I'm doing a zig, oh, like that one right there. Well, let's not hit the rock. But I don't think it'll be the big one. And I'm not stopping and EVA and getting money. I don't need any of that junk. I'm waiting for 2.6. 2.6. Do some Star Marine. Then I can get out and PTU and make some cash. But not really, because 2.6 doesn't really do anything to the universe. Except for the flight model. Star Marine's really where it's at. Okay, so this is a wreck. See all the green little lights? We're just going to zoom right past it. It's a little small little wreck. Now, there's supposed to be one out here that's a giant wreck, and that's what I'm looking for. I don't know if I'll ever see it or find it, but that's what I'm looking for. Not looking for Grim Hex or any of that junk. Even though that's out this way, too. Yeah, we're not there yet. So I'm zigzagging. Asteroid field's very pretty. Trying to help people. It's taking me away from my mission. That's fine though. Helping people, I can do the mission at any time really. I'm just looking for something that I don't have no idea where it is, so I don't mind stopping and like typing. Also, I've kind of felt that the gentleman that I watched his stream, well, not his stream, but he was on a stream with some other players, and they mentioned how there was a large wreck, and they got all excited when they started talking about it and stuff. Oh yeah, you know, blah blah blah. But unfortunately, I've heard them get excited about the littlest things too. So, I mean, I think they overhype things and they over-exaggerate things on that stream like crazy. Like it's I watch it because it's so funny. It's funny how they exaggerate everything and how they're kind of clueless. Because they say a few things and I'm like, they don't know how it's going to work. They're mainstreamers. I mean, if you were to pick the one top streamer out there, he was on that stream. He is always on that stream. You know, and it just I don't know. I don't want to talk bad about people because we all don't know everything, you know? But these guys, they just seem like they are overly excitable. So when I find this large, wreck, I'm going to look at it. I'm going to say, really? Maybe not. Maybe it'll be impressive. And that's what I'm hoping for. I'm trying to find it. So we'll see if it's impressive. There's a green light. I think this is the one that's got pirates near it. I could be wrong. But I think I see a green light right there. It looks fat, so maybe it's the big one. I don't think so. I bet you they don't have any green lights near the big one. Or it's like an Easter egg kind of thing. Like, it's out here, but you gotta find it. Nope, looks like I'm getting ready to zip right past this small wreck. And if they consider this one to be the big one, then they're wrong.
Begin scan.
And yes, there are pirates. No, I didn't.
Shields recharging.
I'm coming for you. I'll do some dogfighting.
Scan. Shields recharging.
How did you die?
Shield under fire. Shields recharging. Over here. Shields recharging. Kill. Shields scan. Contact. Begin scan. Contact. Starboard shield under fire. Flare drop. Flare drop. Shields up.
There is a wreck right here. But that's not it. That can't be it. Oh, you got a treat. Saw me dog fight some pirates. Oh, there's the wreck right there. Cloud around it might be it. It's at my 11 o'clock where that cloud is. There's a second one there. Okay, hang on. Might be onto something.
Scan. Contact.
Okay. This is a good sized wreck, but I don't know if I would consider it to be large.
Shield. 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 Under.
Nah. I mean, it's cool, but I don't think that's it. Just left.
Begin scan. Contact.
Fly off, Civi.
Begin
scan.
Your
business.
I am flying off. Sitting here enjoying my 15 FPS. Not look like a giant wreck. Okay. Wonder if that's a wreck. Okay. I did not find anything in the yellow asteroid field that warranted me saying, ooh, that's a large wreck. No. Nothing. Now, it might not have the green lights in it. So it might be something that's like impossible to find unless you just stumble upon it. If that's the case, then, you know, that's impossible to find it. Here we go. Small wreck. Nothing worth writing home about. Okay. Okay, so I've been searching for 37 minutes. That's how long it took me to dogfight and fly around the yellow asteroid field. Got attacked 3 times. In cruise, zigzagging, looking for this giant wreck. That was proclaimed by a live streamer, a very popular live streamer. But this live streamer also gets overly excited about the stupidest things, littlest things, things that you and I would say, that's no big deal. Or, you know, you're mistaken. Maybe it's just because I'm jaded, I don't know. If it's not at least double the size of a normal wreck, then I don't really count it as large. That they were under the impression, the way they described it, it was like capital ship size. Okay. Comlink restored. Yay! Comlink down. Raw. Okay. At least these asteroids aren't tumbling and zigzagging through each other and, you know, like Empire. At least there's no worm inside one of these asteroids. That's a cave. Let's hide in the cave. Yeah. Sorry. Hey, Master Chief, what's going on? I apologize for the lack of, like, action, but we are, that's not what this stream is supposed to be. I figured I was going to jump on Star Citizen and I was going to look for this asteroid, this specific wreck in the asteroids. So I said, why not just put it on live too? Just let everybody else see too, if they want. You got any questions about Star Citizen? Feel free to ask me. I definitely enjoy helping new players or people that are prospective new players. Talk some sense into you. If you're curious about anything development-wise of Star Citizen, I'm sure I can answer most of your questions. I follow the development process like no other. And I'm also not easily excitable, so just little things that excite a lot of other players don't excite me. It has to be a serious, you know, it has to be breathtaking for it to really excite me. But if you got minor questions or just curious about certain things, feel free to ask. That's what I'm here for. I'll answer questions. I even do it in chat. Hey, Tommy, what's up? That's a good question. Okay, that's actually a pretty good question, Tommy. I'm going to give you two numbers. I'm going to give you two, really not very many, but let me give you two numbers. I've spent more money than just ships, right? So I've spent $750, something like that, on the game in general, just donations and pretty much just donations to Chris and CIG. My ships that I've received from these donations would be a Carrick, a Saber that I'm currently flying, and a Dragonfly. Now you say to yourself, Derek, those ships aren't totaled up to $750. Well, that would be also correct. Because there was a time, about 2 years, that I was a $10 a month subscriber. I'm no longer a subscriber. But there was a time, so what is that? That's like $240 right there, just from being a subscriber. The Carrick, I think, is right at $400. And the Saber is like $170. And the Dragonfly is like $35. So you can do the math. The Carrick game package has evolved over time. It's gradually grown and grown and grown and grown. It was originally an Aurora, and then it became the Dark Pirate. No, name? No, did you change your name? Or has it been like a really long time since you've been to the stream? Just remember, if you're going to be a pirate, I'm going to be hunting you down. Because our squadron's basically a civil defense squadron. We will protect cargo convoys. We will hunt pirates and smugglers. And we'll, of course, defend against alien attacks, of course, like Vandal and stuff like that. We're not instigators. We don't start fights. We finish them. No, we're not even into that. That's not really what we're about. We're about protection. Ooh, excuse me, sorry. This little rock group right here looks kind of cool. But I don't see an asteroid. I mean, I don't see a giant wreck. Yeah, but you don't have to spend anything on ships, really. I mean, that's... Anything that you spend, just understand that you're not really spending it on a ship. I mean, don't, a lot of people think of it that way, but you're not really buying a ship. What you're doing is you're donating to the project. And the reason why I say that is, like this saber that I'm driving right now, it doesn't cost $170 in the game. You don't have to buy it at $170. You could play the game for a month or so and then take your credits and go buy you a... in-game, go buy you a saber. I mean, yeah, this is like, all the ships are that way. You can buy every single ship in the game at some point. You don't have to buy it with cash. Because that's not what you're doing. Your money doesn't go towards the ship, it goes towards the development of the game. They give you a ship as a reward. A lot of people miss, they forget that. Okay, there's a little green dot here, but I bet you it's, I think I've already looked at this one. Might not have, but doesn't look extra giant to me. Looks normal sized. Yeah, I learned a couple of tricks on how to improve my FPS in the game. It's pretty good. It doesn't work. I mean, it's not that big of a deal. It's like +5 to FPS, but hell, I'll take any +5s, right? +5 warp sword. No. Closing your browser. Once you've started, not closing your browser. Once you've started the game, close your launcher. You don't need it anymore. It's already done launching the game. Once the game's launched, Alt Tab, close your launcher. It saves you about 20% of your CPU. And right now, CPU usage is up. It's a prime resource for right now for this game because they haven't optimized GPU usage right now. It doesn't really use your GPU at all. It's using almost 99% of, well, with the launcher open, it was using about 85% of my CPU. And I've got an i7. I have 8 threads. It's not 12 threads or 16 threads. But it is 8 threads isn't shabby. It's a quad core. But it was using like 85% of my i7. And as soon as I closed the launcher, it dropped it to like 60%. And that's with the live stream going. If I turn the live stream off, I get another 5% FPS. Because I'm sitting at 20 FPS right now. That's not horrible, but it's not good either. It's better than my 10 FPS that I have when I go to Korea. You know? I go to Korea, I get like 10 or 15 FPS. And that sucks in a, you know, so by closing my launcher, I get my 5%, get 5 points back, which is pretty good. And then also I do the motion blur restriction. So I restrict motion blur, and that actually gives me a couple points of FPS. Not a whole lot, but it gives me some. And then I keep my stream to 30 FPS, which I was streaming at 60 FPS. And what that did is it used up more of my CPU usage, which caused my game FPS to be even lower. So now I'm only streaming at 30 FPS, close the launcher, restrict motion blur, and I'm doing okay at around 20 FPS. I thought that was a green dot, but I guess, I don't know, let's go a little bit further. Looks like I'm almost at the edge of the asteroid field. Maybe it is on the edge of the asteroid field. So that's not it. It's way too far away. That might be it, but are you going to use a mouse and keyboard or Hotas setup? Hey, Tommy. I am always going to use a mouse and keyboard. With the new, there's a new, what is it, Thrustmaster. There's a new Thrustmaster throttle that has left and right, it's built on the throttle. It has left and right foot pedal buttons, which I thought was super sexy. And it's got a few extra other buttons for flying. I might consider that as a throttle option with the mouse pointer. I am not going to use a joystick. And the reason, but I'm content with the keyboard. I'm happy with the keyboard, actually. But the reason why I don't use a joystick, and I did go out and buy one of those Cytec X55 Rhinos. I did have one of those for about a month, and I played with it, and it was a pretty good joystick. Pretty good. I don't care what other people are saying. Mine didn't malfunction, but it was pretty good. I liked it. But there was a problem, and this is why I'm sticking with mouse and keyboard. I got my setup where the flying the throttle, the joystick, I'm having a good old time. I fly over to Korea. I land. I'm climbing out of my ship. I take the throttle and I move it over here. Take the joystick, I move it over here. I grab my keyboard and I pull it back out. I grab my mouse and I bring it over. And then I go into first-person combat mode, where now I'm using my mouse and keyboard to run around the station first person shooting, right? And then I run back out to my ship, I climb in, I push my mouse out of the way, I get my keyboard out of the way, I grab the throttle and pull it over, I grab the joystick and I pull it over. No, I ain't doing that shit. Sorry. No. I've got my mouse and keyboard. I get out of my ship, I've got my mouse and keyboard. I get back in my ship, I got my mouse and keyboard. I don't want to have to move my stuff around all the time. I was getting kind of excited about the Star Citizen SciTech, you know, specific throttle, keyboard, mouse, and joystick combination thing that they had going on that they wound up not actually doing because SciTech got bought by Logitech and all that stuff. But I was actually considering that as an option. But that fell through. Yeah, if I could figure out a way to have my throttle, my joystick, my mouse, and my keyboard all in front of me without having to move everything out of the way all the time, and without it being uncomfortable, like reaching way over here for the throttle and way over here for the joystick, you know, as long as it all could be like right here and it wasn't a pain to switch back and forth between the two, then I would do a throttle and joystick. Hotas kind of dealio. But no. And plus, I do like gimbaled weapons a lot of the times. I don't have gimbaled weapons now. But me and my squadron were very busy playing in Arena Commander. We would spend nightly, we would spend 2 or 3 hours in Arena Commander playing either against our own team, playing against our own squadron, you know, back and forth, private matches, or we were playing against the Vandal, or we would be playing all the matches, even racing even. We would spend a lot of time doing that. And we experimented with gimbaled weapons versus non-gimbaled weapons versus ballistic weapons versus energy weapons. And we did a lot of experimenting with all those weapons. And then they changed everything, you know. They always do. That's fine. But we don't really get into Arena Command anymore. We're waiting for the beta to come out. And when the beta comes out, we can hash out what our actual loadouts should be and what our flight styles and flight techniques and everything. But while we were doing that, I really liked the gimbaled weapons. And so it's easier to put your gimbaled weapons on target when you're using a mouse. Because then I'm shooting at this circle, right? I'm shooting at the circle with all my guns. You know, and it was a lot easier to fly around shooting at things and point at something and then gun it down, you know, as opposed to always shooting straight forward.
Begin scan.
You chose the wrong part of space to fly through.
This can't be the big one. I mean, it's got a lot of wreckage there, but it's not. I'm gonna dogfight these guys, screw it. Really? Oh shoot.
Overhead shield under fire. Shields recharging. Chaff drop. Chaff drop.
That's all I got, is chaff. I hear you, rear shield under fire.
Run and you die. Fight it.
Yeah.
Come on, shields. Come on, I need you. I don't think it was that big of a mistake.
Shield. Wow.
12 FPS. Wow, look at that. 12 FPS. It's all those inbound missiles. No, they're not coming. That's going to be there until I log out. Wait a second. This is not what I was looking for. But since we're here, I don't know if you guys have had a chance to see Grim Hex yet or not, but here it is. We're coming in. Like from the backside. Another thing, if you haven't ever watched how to get in from the side door, I'll show you that. There's a side door. People don't even know about it. It's very secretive. You can sneak into Grim Hex without ever getting attacked and all that good stuff. Because like you'll land on the landing pad, right? And you'll just get gunned down. People will just... You know, you land on one of these landing pads, people just blow you up or kill you or whatever. So don't. Come over here to see these wrecked gangplanks that normally would have been attached to like bigger capital type ships, like the Idris or what have you. Yeah, check that out. Okay, we're going to sneak in underneath one of these. Get in the darkness. In the shadows. Maybe run into something. Okay, so now you know that I did not land on a landing pad. I'm a little bit off to the right of the Grim Hex where these gangplanks are at. What do they call them? Gangways? Gangways, yeah. And there's a passage right there that people might not even know it's over here. It's functional. And now I'm in a Grimmix. Haha! Some people don't even know about that. Now everybody on the stream knows there's a backdoor. It's a couple of backdoors actually, but that's just one of them. Wait, where's my control button? Okay, what? Ah, that's a bug. I'm sitting at 15 FPS. Well, we didn't find the huge wreck. After an hour. Automatic garbage disposal. It's auto magic. Oh my gosh. Wait, what? Okay. There's a back door right through there. It's auto-magical. Dude, I want a grenade. Or I want that paw right there. Can I get the paw? I want to do some repair work. Can't have the paw. Sucks. I'm gonna unequip that guy. I'm gonna inspect it. There's the scope. I'm gonna equip it. There we go. Since I was here and all, you know. Can I? Ooh, they cleaned this area up over here. Oh, look at that. There used to be a stack of, like, they cleaned that up. Because, like, there's the claymore, and there's the 3D hologram thing. And then in there are some grenades, different types. Where's the barricade, though? I don't see the barricade. It used to be sitting right there. Maybe they're reworking the look of it or something. Yeah, barricade. He's got a claymore. Standing up. Yeah, they got rid of the barricade. It's... How'd they do that? Because they didn't patch, as far as I know. Maybe they did. Maybe it's a sneaky patch. One of them sneaky badges. So we're gonna go test my rifle. I'm gonna see if I go. Outside. Will it pull up with a scope or not? Oh, I don't even have to do that. I can just do this. Where'd my rifle go? There's that rifle. Where's my laser rifle? I could have swore I hit it. Whatever. He stole my frickin' laser rifle. That's new. I am outside. Comes with an endeavor. Should I become a criminal? No. Should I take his endeavor? I don't think the guy knows how to press N. Oh, there he goes. Yeah, he was shooting me. I didn't care. Bringing me straight back to Port Olisar without having to do anything. There's no life or anything. Alright guys, I had a failed search, or maybe I found it and it just wasn't as big as they claimed it to be. So that's it for this stream right now. I'm going to take a short break, maybe get some dinner, and then I'll be back in a little while. I appreciate you guys all coming out and checking out the stream. I do appreciate that. If you want to like and subscribe to the channel, that would be appreciated. And if you want to help support the channel, we have a PayPal in the link below. You guys have a great night.